Hello everyone, hi, and welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. To know more about this video, internal rate of return, watch the video till the end, and also if you're new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon that's given below. Welcome everyone, and today's topic is internal rate of return, one of the most important factor while doing the financial modeling for any company. And this is a part which is used in valuation purpose from DCF perspective or comparable comps or precedent transaction method. It can be any. So IRR is one of the most important factor when it comes to financial modeling or capital budgeting. So let me start with that. You know, internal rate of return is rate basically where the net present value, where the NPV of the project is zero. Okay, so it is a discounting rate by which the future cash flows are adjusted to determine the present value at IRR. And IRR is the minimum required rate of return of the project, and internal rate of return is used to determine the discounting rate by giving the NPV at zero. So IRR is defined as the discount rate that sets the NPV, net present value of the project, to zero. Okay, now how do you calculate NPV? So NPV is equal to your cash flow of zeroth year plus cash flow of first year divided by 1 plus IRR raised to your first year. In a similar fashion, you will do cash flow of second year divided by 1 plus IRR raised to 2. And then it goes on till N. So for calculating the internal rate of return with the help of the IRR formula, the NPV value is set to zero, and then the discount rate is found out. Now the discount rate is then the internal rate of return, IRR value, that we needed to calculate. So due to the character of the formula, however, the IRR cannot be calculated analytically, and it should be instead be calculated either through the trial and the error method or by use of some sort of software system which is programmed to calculate the IRR. So let me give you an example to give you a detailed presentation about this particular topic. See, let's assume that there's a guy called Nick who invests $1,000 in a project A, and he gets a return of, let's say, $1,400 in 1 year of time span, as you can see. Now, what we need to calculate is the IRR of project A. So how will you calculate this? So cost of capital 0 plus 10 till 110. Okay. And let's say in the similar fashion, your NPV keeps changing based on like 400. It will reduce down to 240. Somewhere close to 140, somewhere close to 50, and here it will be zero on 40. So at the cost of capital of 40%, it will be zero value. So you can say that basis the accepted IRR at 40% cost of capital, the NPV will be zero, right? So from the initial graph that we saw, can you see at 40% IRR, the NPV is 400. That means that at 40% IRR, the present value of the cash outflow and the present value of the cash inflow are same, which amounts to zero net present, zero value in terms of you are standing at the break-even point where there is no profit, no loss. Well, now let me teach you that, you know, how exactly the steps will go. The step number one that we'll start with is the cash inflow and outflow in a standard format. So let's say in year one, year zero, one, two, three, four, and five, there are a few cash flows like 50,000, 15, 17, 18, 10, and 10. And then you have the discount rate that is standing at, let's say, 10%. So your NPV will tend to amount to closely around, you can absolutely calculate your NPV here. This is your rate. These are all your values. It is showing us 3862. So your IRR will be is equal to your IRR. So value will include all the cash flows from the project, that is cash outflow and inflow. Okay. That is closely around 14%. Right. So you need to see, this was step number two, to apply the IRR formula in Excel. Now step number three is that you need to compare the IRR with discount rate. How will you do that? So this was your discount rate. This was your IRR 14%. Compare both of them. So from the above calculation, you can see that the NPV generated by the plant is positive and the IRR is closely around 14%, which is more than the required rate of return. And this implies that when the discounting rate is 14%, the NPV will become zero. And hence, XYZ company can invest in this plant. Now, what is the significance of IRR? See, the internal rate of return is much more useful when it is used to carry out the comparative analysis rather than the isolation as one single value. So the higher a project's internal rate of return, the value, the more desirable is to undertake that project as the best available investment option. Now, IRR is basically, you can say that it is uniform for the investments of varied sorts, you can say. And as such, IRR values are often used to rank multiple prospective investment options that a firm is considering on a comparative even basis. Assuming that the amount of the investment is equal among the different available options of investment, the project with the highest IRR value is considered as the best, and that particular option is taken for the first by an investor. So the IRR of any project is calculated by keeping the three assumptions in mind. The first is the investment will be held till maturity. Second, the intermediate cash flows will be reinvested in IRR itself. Third, all the cash flows are, you can say, periodic in nature, or the time gaps between different cash flows are equal. So the IRR value provides the organization with the rate of growth that can be expected to be obtained by making an investment in the project considered, while the actual internal rate of return obtained may vary from theoretical value that we have calculated. The highest value will surely provide the best growth rate among all. So the most common use of the internal rate of return is seen with the organization uses to consider investing in new project or to increase the investment in a currently ongoing project. So as an example, we can take a case of energy company that opts to start a new plant or to expand the working of a current working plant. So the decision in this case can be taken by calculating the IRR and thus finding out which of the options will provide the higher net. Now, the required rate of return is known as the hurdle rate. So the hurdle rate is the required rate of return, which is the minimum return that is expected by an organization on the investment they are making. So most organizations keep a hurdle rate, and any project with an internal rate of return exceeding the hurdle rate is considered as profitable. Although this is not the only basis for considering a project investment, hurdle rate is an effective mechanism in screening out the project which will not be profitable or profitable enough. So usually a project with the highest difference between the hurdle rate and IRR is considered to be the best project in investing in. So there is one thing called independent projects, that is IRR here is greater than the your cost of capital, COC. There are independent projects where the IRR is less than the COC, then reject the project. So here, accept the project if the IRR is greater than the cost of capital, and here reject the project. So there are thumb rules to be followed while using the IRR calculation. First, the invested amount is always taken as negative values. So if you receive an amount of six, let's say if you invest 100, it is taken as minus 100. Second, the money you gain is always taken as your positive value. So if you can receive amount of 60, then it is taken as 60. Third, by default, all payments are taken as yearly basis, either at the start or at the end of the year. So it can be even be compared to the prevailing rates of return within the security market. So if a firm cannot notice any investment option with an internal rate of return values more than the return which will be generated within the monetary markets, it may merely opt to invest in retained earnings into the market. So even though you can say that internal rate of return is considered as a standalone metric with a great importance, it should always be used as the conjunction with the NPV for getting a clearer picture of the project's potential in earning the organizations a better profit. What exactly are the disadvantages of this particular thing? Let's understand. The need for the use of the NPV in conjunction is considered to be a big drawback of the IRR. Although it is considered as an important metric, it cannot be useful when it is used alone. So the problem arises in situations where the initial investment gives a small IRR value but a greater NPV value. Now, this happens on the project which gives a profit at a slower pace, but these projects may benefit in enhancing the overall value of the organization. Now, a similar problem is when a project gives a faster paced result for a short period of time. A small project may seem to be giving a large profit in short time, giving a greater IRR value but a lower NPV value. So the project length has a greater significance in this case. Another problem, if you see, with the internal rate of return is that which is not strictly inherent to the metric itself, but related to some typical misuse of the IRR. And individuals might assume that once positive cash flows are generated throughout the course of the projects, the money will be reinvested in the project's rate of return. So this may seldom be not the case. Rather, once the positive cash flows are reinvested, it will be at a rate that represents the value of the total capital employed, which is misreading the, or you can say misusing the IRR. In this way, it could result in conclusion that a project is a lot more profitable than it is, than it truly is. Another common drawback is termed as the multiple IRR. What is multiple IRR? Multiple IRR drawbacks occurs in case where the cash flows in the course of the project's lifespan are negative. That is, the project operates at a loss or the organization needs to contribute additional capital. This is referred as the non-normal cash flow situation, and such cash flows can provide multiple internal rate of return. Now, these drawbacks of multiple internal rate of return occurrence and the inability to handle multiple duration projects have been brought up the need for a better procedure to find out the best project to invest in. And so a new modified metric, which is known as the modified internal rate of return, or it is known as short MIRR, is designed. So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching the video, please like, comment, and subscribe to our channel for all the latest updates. Thank you everyone once again for joining the session.